Good morning, YouTube. Today, we're gonna get the 525 running again, and we're gonna check out some more stuff on the 430.
So are you recording all of the nefarious activities?
If you're new to the channel, my name is Dan, and we are at the Howard, and that is Josh.
Yo.
And we have a bunch of parts, so we're gonna get the 525 so it's driving on its own again. So we got the new potentiometer. We're gonna put that in. That should be fairly easy, although the battery's completely dead, so it's still got some sort of parasitic draw, which is frustrating to say the least. We also have the 430, which we just got, and we wanted to get it up on the lift and look underneath it and see how all the bushings are, the engine mounts, all that stuff, just to give you confidence in the car. So these cars are both gonna be for sale. So if you wanna talk to us about making a deal, send us an email, sales@ngsupercars.com. And if you have any parts that you wanna buy from us, go check out normalguysupercar.com. Use the code NGS10 at hook, see up to 10% off most of the things we sell. So let's have at it, and hopefully we can get these both figured out today.
Here we got the potentiometer.
You almost pulled a Dan.
Yeah, shit. The way it works is that there's this little rod right here. It's like a ball joint sort of deal. And so it attaches to the pedal. So when you press the pedal, it moves like this, and there's a resistor in there, and it tells the car how far you've pressed the pedal in. Well, for whatever reason, on our old one here, it's
no working.
It's wasted. We'll put the part number and stuff in the description so you know what it is.
Yeah.
I feel like this is probably pretty uncommon for these to go out, but...
I've heard that they're not super uncommon to go
yeah.
out.
They're pretty easy to replace. It just, you know, the screws are hard to get to, but other than that, it just kind of snaps in there.
It's
so
common enough that 5 dealerships couldn't fix it.
Yeah.
And that's why they kept auctioning it off.
The symptoms of it are unusual.
You know, on a lot of cars in the past that I've worked on, I've seen these go bad. BMWs and Mercedes and Audis especially. Sometimes they're in the pedal and sometimes it's actually built into the throttle body.
Oh wow.
Depending on the car. So yeah, when they go out, they do all sorts of weird stuff, so.
Yeah, I mean, clearly the behavior this car exhibited was very unusual.
So we'll get it running again. I'm looking forward to driving it.
Yes.
Because I've not driven this car yet.
No. Neither have you.
I have not. I'm excited too as well. These are the types of Ferraris I think I would be interested in. Like nice grand touring, nice...
Comfy as hell.
Yeah.
Okay. Classy.
Tool boy.
Oh,
yeah. Go get me a socket that fits on there. Don't drop that.
So while Josh is working on that, I just wanted to quickly talk about the 430. So as you know, we like to disclose everything that we know that gets wrong with these things.
I dropped the thing on accident.
Did you really?
The thing that Josh...
The thing that he said, don't drop.
Lose that part.
Where did it go?
That's what holds the little ball joint together. If that thing's not there, it'll pop out.
Oh my god. Anywho, so one of the things we like to do is drive these cars before we sell them because we want to make sure that they're sorted. And we've been getting a weird slowdown and F1 light all at the same time, only when it comes to stop. I think it's probably because the battery in this car is junk. We already knew that. We already have an anti-gravity on order. It should be here in the next few days. So we'll replace that and we'll show you the guys that. If you need an anti-gravity battery, go check out normalguysupercar.com. We sell those. Use the code NGS10, it takes off 10%. They're amazing. We actually have one in the 575. As you know, the 575 is dead because it's got parasitic draw, but theoretically the battery should have held a reserve. So we should still be able to start it. So we're gonna actually test that theory in just a little bit. So hopefully the battery being replaced in this car will sort it out and get it so that we don't get that light anymore. We want this car to be running correctly. We don't want that happening. So hopefully that goes away. So we'll keep you guys informed on that, but we'll get it up on the lift and check it out in just a minute. So first thing I want to check is the F1 fluid. To get access to that, we just have to remove this panel right here. I think there are 3 or 4 millimeter Allens. I don't remember, but anyway, we'll get that panel off. Then the reservoir will be right there and we should be able to check on it. Okay, we got the panel off. This is the F1 reservoir. The F1 pump is right there. And somewhere up there is the accumulator. So what we're gonna do is just pop off this cap. Come on, tight. And how much fluid do we have? I don't see any in the stick.
It's like almost totally empty.
Well, that would cause a problem.
Well, there you go, there's your problem. All right, looks like we're gonna go get some F1 fluid. All right, we got the car in the air. Before I pull off the bottom tray, just wanna show you, okay, so diffuser does have scrapes. Yeah, well, that's pretty usual. Let's take a look at the ball joints. Hey, look at that. The ball joint little gasket is actually not torn.
Sweet.
That's amazing. CV boot looks good over here. How's it look over here? Oh yeah, that one's looking pretty solid too. Yeah, it's not bad. Let's look up here. Oh yeah, that's actually really clean.
Yeah, super.
Good ball joints. I wonder if those have been replaced, because those...
looks like they probably have.
I bet those have been replaced. Because those are they're too good a shape for this old of a car.
No leaking on the shocks or anything?
Yeah, no leaks anywhere on this whole front end. Let's see, how's the... Oh yeah, by the way, this has scrape guards. Yes, it's got the big ones. You can see, still got some scrape right here. That's unfortunate. But pretty solid shape otherwise. Yeah, a little bit of scraping right there. That's really clean. Yeah, that's great. Very nice. Oh, a little bit of scrape there on the underside. Well, that happens. All right, YouTube, on the underside. Looks like a little bit of oil here. Probably didn't seal that correctly. That's my guess. Otherwise, everything else looks kind of dry. Oh, actually, yeah. Hey, look at that. Engine mounts are actually in reasonably good shape. I'll be damned. That's a rarity. CV boots look good over here and good over here. I don't see any leaks coming out of the valve covers. Nope, neither side. Both are dry. That's excellent. No leaks up here. Yeah, this is pretty clean. This is really good. Yeah, very good shape. All right, that makes me happy. Hooray. Yeah, I'm pretty pleased with this. So a little bit of weeping on the oil on the side of the transmission where it meets the engine. That's not unusual. A tiny bit of seepage on, looks like maybe from the AC area. Belts are fine, everything else looks fine. So just, it's not even enough to put oil onto the pan. So insignificant. Valve gasket's good, everything else looks good. No other leaks. This is pretty damn good shape. We're saying this is on the upper end of clean cars. How's the suffering?
Almost done. It's just so tight in there. You have to put a bolt through whatever they didn't thread it, and you gotta put a locking nut on the other side, and the bolt is really long, so it's just a pain in the butt.
It looks uncomfortable.
It is, and there's not a lot of room to work in here, and I'm too tall for this shit.
Oh, good news, we did get some tires ordered. They should be here in a few days. They're Michelin Pilot Sport 4S's, which I think are the best tires you can get on these cars. New tires, we're gonna get the fluid topped off in the F1 system in just a little bit, and hopefully that solves the F1 issue I've been seeing. I think that's gonna be it. And then of course the battery should be here next week, and then she's ready, man. That's all it needs. That's all this thing needed. Oh, and an oil change. We got to order that stuff. That should be here in a few days. And we gotta play the car shuffle. Might as well get the startups of the glorious Klein Inconel exhaust on this 458.
What are we doing exhaust on this?
I know, right? Okay, so we got the dead car. We're gonna kick on the anti-gravity battery. I'll show you how to do that. So there is the button, the restart button, and you clicked it.
Got power.
All right, it's supposed to be enough to give you one start.
All right, let's see.
Okay. Oh, she's unhappy. Come on. She haven't started in probably a month. But hey, the battery worked. So I think, yeah, you're supposed to, once it gets running, tap that off. So let's tap it off. There it goes. All right. Hooray. Nice. Like we should get that Klein.
Yeah, maybe we should.
Because this thing would sound epic with that.
The next pipe and the Klein.
Oh. Josh, what do we have?
Redline D4ATF.
Ooh.
That's the best alternative to the Shell
Donuts
Nutella stuff.
Yeah, Nutella. Shell Nutella.
It's flavorful.
Yeah.
So we're just going to add a little of that, top off the F1 system. I think that's going to help it run a little better, hopefully not get the F1 lightning work. Also, we bought new windshield wiper blades because we noticed that the one blade was torn. So we're just going to replace those real quick because, whatever, they're cheap and no one needs a stupid wiper blade falling apart on them. Ooh, careful. It's going to puke out anyway.
Yeah.
They always do. Doesn't matter how much you do it right, it'll always puke out.
Where's it supposed to be on here?
I think it's between those two lines.
Okay, so we're good then.
Yeah. It'll still probably puke out when it gets hot. When you get home and turn it off, it'll probably have a puddle.
Cool.
So that, I guess, blades? Okay.
Yeah, let's figure out how to do these.
They're easy. Usually like this little tab, and they come back. It's like a little U-shaped thing.
Is that your head?
That was my head on the windshield.
Nice. All right, so I tricked the car. I turned on the wiper blades, and I quickly turned it off while I was running. So there you go. Now you can actually get these up in the air and pop it off. So there's a tab on the bottom. You push the tab, and then it should come off.
Just for anybody that's curious, the passenger side is a 21 inch, and the driver's side is a 24 inch.
Oh, there you go. New blades. All set. Yeah, the old ones were kind of falling apart.
Yeah, they're looking pretty janky.
All buttoned up. She's ready to rock and roll. We'll find out if we get that air anymore, if it gets the F1 light anymore. If it does, I do think it could be the battery still, so we need to basically drive it and see if we get the air, and then if it does, then, you know, we'll get the battery put in as soon as that arrives, which should be next week. Oh yeah, let's see.
Here we go.
Oh, it started right up.
Started right up.
Here we go.
Yep.
See if we fixed it.
Better be.
I'm not gonna flog it until it warms up. Oh yeah, it's fixed. I can already tell.
Nice.
Hell yeah.
Get a burble.
I love that. I love that.
You drive enough these Ferraris, you can tell what generation the programming is.
Yeah.
Just by the way they behave.
Yep. Ship. Yeah, their AC blows cold.
Yeah.
You know, even though this is like a generation of the 360.
Well, it's got the 430 trans stuff.
Everything about it is like that generation, but it feels way more solid than a 360. Like, yep. Way more like a tank.
Oh, yeah. No, I think they build the V12s better.
They must. Or maybe it's just because everything is like thicker. I don't know. It just feels more solid.
I love that grumble.
Yeah.
Just sitting here idling, it's like...
Cars in such good shape.
I know. All right, I do want to convert it, but I think if someone
a gated shifter right here would be badass.
Yeah, I think if someone offered us 155 on tank.
Yeah.
Without doing the belts.
Right.
Like, so if you offer us 155, it's yours.
Oh shit. Lots of torque.
Yeah. Totally different feeling, huh?
Oh yeah. I could definitely go on a road trip in this car.
Yep.
It's way more comfortable than the mid-engine cars. Here we go, let's see what this thing's got. We're up to temperature now.
Yeah. Careful, tires are shit.
Oh, that's right. Okay. Here we go. Oh yeah, they're shit. Oh, Jesus. This thing keeps pulling. It doesn't want to quit pulling.
Is that awesome?
It's pretty awesome.
I mean, it's not stupid fast, but it's fun.
No, this thing is plenty fast.
Yeah.
I like that the torque just doesn't stop. Like
it's
in the
super linear.
In a 360 or whatever, the torque kind of like, you can feel it weakening when it gets towards the red line, but this thing was just like, you know, pulling the whole time.
The higher the R and the RPMs, the more it pulls.
Oh, that exhaust sounds good too.
I know. We need that Klein.
With that Klein would, yeah. Oh yeah, I can see why people like these. If I had the money, I'd have one of these, I think. I would have to have a mid-engine one too, but this would be a great, go on a leisurely hill country drive by yourself sort of deal.
Everyone keeps saying that as soon as my 599's done, I'm not going to want to sell it.
That's probably a valid point.
I'm suspicious if that's not going to be true.
Well, for the amount of money it's worth, I think you'll want to sell it.
Yeah, that's the problem.
For the money, this is, you know,
this isn't bad as a F1, as a manual, it's crazy.
Oh, as a manual, this thing would be ridiculous. It handles good, too. I mean, it handles like a heavy car, but...
Oh, 100 kilometers. 100 kilometers an hour. It's like 62.
We have some Pilot Supersports on order because apparently the 4S's are on national back order for like 6 months or something for the size for this car.
Yeah.
So they can only get us the Supersports, which the Supersports are still great tires. I still love those
tires. Better than what's on it.
Oh, hell yeah.
Right now it's got like 14-year-old bricks.
Yeah.
Another day in the life of normal guy and supercars. This car is for sale at $126,900. The 535, if you want it as is, 155. No negotiations on that. 155, you can take it as is. Otherwise, we're converting it, and the conversion starts very, very soon. So if you want it, you're gonna have to like decide within the next like day. Jag has got a possible offer. Corvette just sold. So we'll be getting some more cars. We got some deals we're working on. So stay tuned for all that. Hit us up, sales@ngsupercars.com. If you want any of our inventory, go check out normalguysupercar.com. If you need some parts or services. And as always, we do appreciate when you guys can like, share, and subscribe. That literally helps us out, so thank you so much. But we're gonna be doing a lot of cool car stuff. You're gonna wanna stay tuned. It's gonna be sweet.